Hello. About 2 years ago, when I moved into Rose Cottage, I transferred to rose bushes. I was clearing the front garden to put in a parterre. The parterre is doing incredibly well. And these are the two roses I moved. So they've been in these tubs now for 2 years. So as an update to the original video, removing or transferring rose bushes, they did very well for the first 18 months. But sadly, I've rather neglected them, and they've been sat in these tubs now without any food and very little water for 2 years. So I was quite pleased with the fact that they recovered very, very strongly after they were first moved. However, I'm a little bit disappointed in myself for neglecting them. So we're going to do another experiment now and give them a second lease of life. And you will see the results of this experiment at the end of this video. I'm not going to keep you waiting. I won't be publishing this until I've got some results from these roses. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get them out of these tubs, use a high pressure hose pipe to take all the soil and all those weeds away, prune them quite hard and put them in fresh compost. And then hopefully they will spring back into life. Now, it is July. Ideally, you would do this when these roses were dormant, but I don't want to wait till next spring to do this. I'm going to do it now in July, and then hopefully we've got just enough warm growing season left this year for these to show some signs of recovery. So let's get on with getting them out of the pots, cleaning them all up, pruning them and repotting them. So because I intend pruning them anyway, the first thing I'm going to do is give them a really hard prune. It'll make them easier to handle. So I'm just taking all the spiky growth off the top. The encouraging thing about this is it looks alive. There's green in there. So that means that that plant is not dead yet. It's probably not far off. So that's why I didn't want to wait till the springtime. And again, we'll do the same. I'm just doing this quite roughly, and there's no finesse to this. Let's just get all those branches out the way so that we can handle it without scratching ourselves. These are supposed to be thorn-proof gardening gloves, by the way, and I do find them to be very effective. This leather surface is very resistant to thorns, so that is much easier to tackle now, so I'll be able to get that out without injuring myself. The second surset, the loppers and the gloves, are available in my Amazon shop, and I shall put the links below this video. So the next thing I shall do is get these out and wash all the soil off and get rid of all the weeds. I did give these a really good soak, so they should, in theory, be quite hydrated, which will make them more able to cope with the shock that they are about to have. So that's one out of its tub. Let's get the other one out. You can see that these are very mature roses. And out it comes. Right. Before I tackle getting the hose pipe on them, I'm just going to use my grubbing hoe just to hack away a little bit. Again, another useful tool, the grubbing hoe. It's great. It's like my right hand. It's just great for getting in there and I know it looks a bit destructive, this, but it'll do the rose the world of good when it's in its new home. And all these weeds have been sharing the nutrients in the soil, so again, it'll be a lot happier when it's got fresh soil to grow into. I just realised there's an ant's nest in here. I wonder if they've done any good or any harm to this rose. If you've watched the original video, you'll recognise what you're about to see, which is a great big lump of root. And you see that? That is full of food carbohydrates. We'll give that a good clean and then we'll repot it. This is spent. And we'll do the same with the other one. The soil is coming away very easily, and the reason it's coming away very easily is because it's wet, because I've given it a really good soak.
There's the other one. Again, that's spent. That can go on the compost. And now we will deal with these. Right, hose pipe. Let's get this soil all off these rose roots. And we'll have a quick look at the anatomy, and I'll remove all these weeds. Showing them no mercy. But it will do good and good, I promise you. It surprises me always how very little fibrous roots they have, these roses. I might just turn the power down a bit just to get in there. It's almost like a bare root rose, isn't it? Let's do the other one. That's a bit of grass that can come out. It's not welcome. Again, some grass there, which is coming away. This is going to be soil and rose and nothing else. So I've got two fresh pots here, and I am just going to plant them up to their original soil level, no deeper. And I'm going to leave a bit of an inch at the top of these pots so that I can water them. So that's going to be about right in that pot. And that, you can see there where soil level was, will be fine in that pot. Let's get some compost in. I'm just breaking up the lumps that are in this compost before I plant into it. Right, there it is. Dig a hole. In fact, I shall place some of that in there and then backfill it. In it goes. Snug, but there is plenty of space for that to be sustained. And now let's just fill it up. And you might think, is it worth it for such an old rose? Well, in a way, I kind of want to prove the point that these roses are much more resilient than I think we give them credit for. These have really gone through the mill. They've been dug up from my front garden. And then I remember I shoved them in the ground in a place where I thought they were going to be permanent. But turned out that that wasn't the case. So they were dug up again and shoved in these tubs. So they've been moved several times and they've, you know, gone through the wars, but seem to survive. I will do a bit more pruning on this because I can see some of these branches have got dieback on them. So I will do a bit more pruning. And I will do diagonal cuts just above an outward facing bud so that it grows out in a kind of an open bowl shape. Right, that's one. Let's get the other one in. And of course, in about a minute or so, you are going to see the results of this. As I've already alluded to, I'm not going to publish this video until we've got the results. So this is going to be one of those videos where you get immediate gratification. Again, I'm breaking up the lumps in this compost. In goes the root. Just gently sprinkle the soil around the root without doing too much damage to the root. And then fill up again with a bit more. I missed with half of it. Good compost, this. I paid a bit extra for this. It was about £8 a bag, which is more than I normally pay for compost. I ought to try and make my own because it's getting very expensive. Right. Again, that one is in there. Perhaps with a bit more on top of that. Time flies now. You're going to see the results of. I hope it hurries up and starts growing again. Let's get some more pruned off and then give them a good water. And in about 10 seconds, you will see the results. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And so here are the results. And such is the power of nature and the resilience of the rose. That original video was filmed on the 8th of July. We are now on the 30th of July. So this is almost exactly 3 weeks later. And don't forget, we removed all the soil from these roses, which had previously been moved twice before. And look at this, already after only 3 weeks, beautiful fresh growth here and here, down at the back there, over there. It's universally all across the plant growing back, you can see there. And we are at the end of July. I think I've done this just in time because this plant now has the rest of the summer and the growing season to re-establish some fresh roots in here and continue to grow. I will keep it here in this sheltered space where it won't get too much sunlight, it won't get too much variation. I will keep it well watered, I will keep it well weeded, and already we are starting to see weeds here. I'm going to treat this rose with a bit more respect, keep it well watered, and eventually this rose will be the centerpiece of a rose garden at Rose Cottage. Isn't that amazing, really, when you think about it? I think the root must have quite a lot of energy store. That great big lump of wood under there has quite a lot of energy store. And this is how these things have evolved, you know. They've evolved to survive. Nature does. Let's have a look at the other one, because it wasn't just about this one. There were two, don't forget. And again, let's zoom in a little bit closer and you can see there, look. Just at my fingertip, some growth. And just there at my fingertip, some more growth. Down here, some fresh growth. This rose is going to come back, and it's going to come back strong. We don't have a lot of growth down here. I think we can probably say that that particular branch is gone, but we do have a nice branch here. Look, we'll end up with a lovely rose bush. We'll end up with two wonderful rose bushes, and I can't wait to see these next springtime produce some beautiful, fragrant rose blossoms. Incidentally, while we're here, look at the way I've cut these at a diagonal, and I've pruned to an outward facing bud so that this will grow out into an open bowl shape. Can you see there? Look, that will grow out there, and that's what I'll continue to do. Wonderful. Expect to see these again in future videos. Sadly, I have lost 4 dogs in the last few years, and I have got their ashes, and I may well do a remembrance garden, and these roses can go in there. It feels fitting. Hope you've enjoyed that. Hope it's been interesting and useful. Probably some more dead wood there that can be taken off. And I'll see you soon for some more rose rehabilitation adventures. Wonderful. Bye for now.